In this video, I'm going to assign some functions to some of the pins on the variable frequency drive, which should allow me to add an emergency stop, use a potentiometer, and a few other things that I've got planned. I'd like to connect the pump, which will cool the spindle, to the VFD via some kind of relay, or some kind of timer relay in fact, so that it turns on when the spindle turns on and remains on for possibly 5 to 10 minutes after a job is completed. This is the NF-Lixin variable frequency drive. There isn't much information about it online apart from a video I made explaining the process in which I problem solve setting up the machine to turn the spindle on for the first time. The manual is very complicated, but there's a lot of typos and interesting use of language, which isn't necessarily what you want from a manual, but I got this for free, and that's the price I have to pay. The first thing I've done is assigned the X1 terminal a function which is as an emergency stop, so I should be able to connect this to the emergency stop and turn the machine off. I'm just going to turn this on now. Now if I turn the spindle on, this is what I would see on the panel if the spindle was running, and then when I press this switch it goes to zero. This is a momentary switch, but the Estop would be a latching one, so it would turn this off plus the power going to the controller, so hopefully that would stop the machine running even when I reset the controller. So every VFD will be a little bit different in terms of how the parameters are set. In this case, if I go to the page 21 and 22 of the manual, and 23, I've got the explanation of the control circuit terminals, and then X1, X2, X3, X4, 5 and 6 have different parameters that I can then go to and then set the functionality, and depending on what these are, there might be a parameter set in terms of time, on off, or in this case 99 kinds of multifunction inputs, which is a big number. So I've done the first one. I'm just going to now change multifunction, the multifunction digital input setting for X2, and that's function number 40, well, that's program number 42. And then I need to decide what to set that to. Now I think for the VFD to be controlled by the controller, I need to change a particular setting, which is the source of speed and control order changeover. But what I'd like to do is set that onto a switch. So I set the speed in the software on the G code. In case something goes wrong, I can press a button and then have access to the potentiometer. And I think that would be quite useful. Need to go to, obviously when you're doing something like this, obviously be careful not to touch any live wires. I try to keep this neat as possible, but obviously you know, there's certain things in which I could electrocute myself on, so I'm gonna try and be sensible. So I need to go, I think it's parameter, I think that's actually what PR stands for, and I'm gonna go to 42. And then you press the OK button, which I think is this RDWT button. So it's set to zero at the moment, which is no any action, null. And X1, I set that to 1, which is the emergency stopping. And there's lots of things here, so inching and kind of fault reset. I'm not sure what flip-flop stands for, but anyway, motor overheat protection functionality, normally closed type of detector. So anyway, I'm going to go to I'm going to set zero now to source of speed and control order changeover. Go to 10 and 90. And then, okay, I'm going to set that to memory. And then you press that, which is CLT. Alright, so I'm just going to turn this off. Really, there's large capacitors in this, and you should really leave it for 5-10 minutes before poking around, but I feel a little bit cocky. And I'm just going to put that over now to X2. So I'm connecting X2 and digital comm, which I think is the common ground. What I think will happen is when I press this button, I won't be able to use the potentiometer. Okay, let's see what happens. Clunk. Okay, that's speed. Pressed. It's dropped down to zero. And obviously the potentiometer is not doing anything. I'll just zoom in. So that's not doing anything. Let go of the button and it's gone back to this particular functionality. But I want this to work the opposite way. I want to have the pulse width modulation as the main source of speed control and to only change over to the potentiometer when I switch over. I also don't know if I'd even assign the pulse width modulation because I don't have a signal coming in which I can check. Now what I want to do is find the function which originally I'd set quite some time ago to allow me to use the potentiometer and set it back to whatever the input is for the PWM and the spindle enable. So I've got about 50 minutes of footage where I attempt to assign various functions to the X2 digital input with varying success. But instead of showing all that trial and error, I'll jump to what I did which eventually made the switchover work, in an order that I would advise to do it. To run the spindle from the controller, you are going to need a PWM or pulse width modulation signal and a spindle enable signal. The spindle enable signal goes to the X5 digital input pin, which is assigned value 73 as a factory preset via parameter 45 to run the spindle in forward. The X5 terminal would normally go to the control board, but for now I put a piece of wire from it to the DCOM or digital common ground terminal, which means when the VFD is turned on, it automatically enables the spindle in a forward direction. And then I'm going to take a little bit of wire and just jump between the ground and the next five, and that. So this should just turn on automatically. The spindle should turn on when this is on. I hope this isn't going to cause any problems. Turning on. To set the speed, I use AI1, which is an analog input interface. Again, this would normally come from the controller with the speed set in G-code. The signal from my controller is 0 to 10 volts, although other controllers may vary. The voltage will adjust the frequency driving the spindle, which in my case goes between 0 and 400 Hz. So a signal of 10 volts means 400 Hz goes to the spindle, which is 100% of the RPM speed.
I've connected the AI1 pin to the DC voltage output on the soldering station to act like a false PWM signal. Providing I don't go over 10 volts, this will work fine.
So this is acting like the PWM, the pulse width modulation, so I should be able to turn that on and then change the speed based on the voltage I send into the VFD.
You can set a minimum voltage in case you are using an air-cooled spindle, which wouldn't have sufficient cooling if the spindle doesn't run above a certain RPM. I'm using a water-cooled spindle, so this is set from zero. I then assign the function of the X2 pin via parameter 42 to 88, which is the speed command switchover. Now on page 67, you will find subsection 6.3, the way of set operational frequency, which I think means how to set the operational frequency.
It seems that you can set two functions either side of a decimal place.
And here you can set two functions which will act in a do this first until that happens, which is now X2 being triggered, and then do something else. I set this via function 40, firstly to 1, which is the AI1 0 to 10 volt pulse width modulation input. Then after the decimal point, I put the number 25, which means the frequency is decided by the input of AI3, in other words, the keyboard potentiometer.
This. Okay, so now the spindle is on. But I need to turn on the PWM, which will set. It's gone to the potentiometer. Oh my god, it fucking works! If I want to go back, I can let go of this and it goes to the speed set by that thing over there. So that's acting as the PWM coming in from the control board. I press my button and then I have access to the potentiometer. Now, I've not seen anyone do that on any of the controller builds using variable frequency drives. So I am pretty chuffed with myself right now. And then, and obviously to turn it off, that's still relying on the signal to X5. Amazing. Off. Boom. Clearly I need to make sure whatever this button is, it's a latching one. Because I don't particularly want to keep my finger on the button. What I can also do as well is either pull the panel up to the top of the controller here so I have access to it,
or connect a potentiometer to the AI3 pin. Anyway, I think I'm going to leave this video on a high, and in the next video properly wire everything to the variable frequency drive and its controller. I had a few goes at connecting a relay for the spindle cooling pump, but wasn't getting the results I was expecting, so we'll come back to that in a future video. Anyway, thanks again for watching and see you next time.